O come, let us worship God, and bow low before the God who made us, for he is the Lord our God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and with your spirit. Welcome to Mass on Tuesday in the fifth week in ordinary time. We offer our Mass for the repose of the soul of Margaret Hanson. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God for ever and ever. Amen. A reading from the book of Genesis. God said, let the waters teem with living creatures, and let birds fly above the earth within the vault of heaven. And so it was. God created great sea serpents and every kind of living creature with which the waters teem, and every kind of winged creature. God saw that it was good. God blessed them, saying, be fruitful, multiply, and fill the waters of the sea, and let the birds multiply upon the earth. Evening came and morning came, the fifth day. God said, let the earth produce every kind of living creature, cattle, reptiles, and every kind of wild beast. And so it was. God made every kind of wild beast, every kind of cattle, and every kind of land reptile. God saw that it was good. God said, let us make man in our own image, in the likeness of ourselves, and let them be masters of the fish of the sea, the birds of heaven, the cattle, all the wild beasts and all the reptiles that crawl upon the earth. God created man in the image of himself. In the image of God he created him. Male and female he created them. God blessed them, saying to them, be fruitful, multiply, fill the earth and conquer it. Be masters of the fish of the sea, the birds of heaven, and all living animals on the earth. God said, see, I give you all the seed-bearing plants that are upon the whole earth, and all the trees with seed-bearing fruit. This shall be your food. To all wild beasts, all birds of heaven, and all living reptiles on the earth, I give you the foliage of plants for food. And so it was. God saw all he had made, and indeed it was very good. Evening came and morning came, the sixth day. Thus heaven and earth were completed with all their array. On the seventh day, God completed the work he had begun. He rested on the seventh day after all the work he had been doing. God blessed the seventh day and made it holy, because on that day he had rested after all his work of creating. Such were the origins of heaven and earth when they were created. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. How great is your name, O Lord our God, through all the earth. How great is your name, O Lord our God, through all the earth. When I see the heavens, the work of your hands, the moon and the stars which you arranged, what is man that you should keep them in mind, mortal man, that you care for him. How great is your name, O Lord our God, through all the earth. Yet you have made him little less than a god. With glory and honour you crowned him, gave him power over the works of your hand, put all things under his feet. How great is your name, O Lord our God, through all the earth. All of them, sheep and cattle, yes, even the savage beasts, birds of the air and fish that make their way through the waters. How great is your name, O Lord our God, through all the earth. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Bend my heart to your will, O Lord, and teach me your law. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. The Pharisees and some of the scribes who had come from Jerusalem gathered round Jesus, and they noticed that some of his disciples were eating with unclean hands, that is, without washing them. For the Pharisees and the Jews in general followed the tradition of the elders and never eat without washing their arms as far as their elbow. And on returning from the marketplace, they never eat without first sprinkling themselves. There are also many other observances which have been handed down to them concerning the washing of cups and pots and bronze dishes. So these Pharisees and scribes asked him, "Why do your disciples not respect the tradition of the elders, but eat their food with unclean hands?" He answered, "It was of you hypocrites that Isaiah so rightly prophesied in this passage of Scripture. This people honors me only with lip service, while their hearts are far from me. The worship they offer me is worthless. The doctrines they teach are only human regulations. You put aside the commandment of God to cling to human traditions." And he said to them, "How ingeniously you get round the commandment of God in order to preserve your own traditions. For Moses said, 'Do your duty to your father and your mother, and anyone who curses father or mother must be put to death.' But you say, 'If a man says to his father or mother, anything I have that I might have used to help you is korban, that is, dedicated to God, then he is forbidden from that moment to do anything for his father or mother.' In this way you make God's word null and void for the sake of your tradition, which you have handed down. And you do many other things like this." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. This morning in the first reading, we continue to hear the sacred creation text proclaim, which tells us that every step of creation is planned and willed by God. It cannot be reduced to just a random occurrence. "Let us make," says God. That's a consideration of the heavenly court, an action of the Blessed Trinity, who wills that creation should share in the life of the Creator. And that life, especially man, and that has a collective meaning for all humanity, is to share in the image and likeness of God. Man is to be intelligent and social. This will mark humanity out from all other creatures. Man will be granted dominion over the earth. But it is a stewardship, for it always belongs to God. The likeness we share is not physical, because God has no body. It is a spiritual likeness and is the basis of our ability to have an interior life which needs nourishment. Remember, man does not live on bread alone, but by every word that comes forth from the mouth of God. This capacity of the thou and the I, of a personal relationship, brings the capacity of having a covenant that God will keep us in mind, and even when we fall away from him, he will seek and find us and call us back to him. The words of Scripture show that man is the only creature that God has loved for itself alone. For all other creatures are at the service of humanity. But that does not give us license to abuse creation or indeed any other person willed and chosen by God. Our lives are to be fruitful. Here perhaps is the first understanding of marriage as part of God's plan for humanity, the means by which family is to be structured and flourish. And from the family, all vocations are begun, nurtured and replenished. Here is where we learn that our life finds meaning in service of God and family, and later of his church and his people. For the way God intends to intervene in human history is primarily through us. But when we do not respond as we should, he has already worked out the remedy, the incarnation of our Lord Jesus Christ, who redeems and restores our humanity to its original holiness. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. O Lord our God, who once established these created things to sustain us in our frailty, grant, we pray, that they may become for us now the sacrament of eternal life, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. And with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son you created the human race, so also through him you, with great goodness you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Richard our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen.
At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always, and with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let them thank the Lord for his mercy, his wonders for the children of men, for he satisfies the thirsty soul, and the hungry he fills with good things. O God, who have willed that we be partakers in the one bread and one chalice, grant us, we pray, so to live that, made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God.